Welcome. In this video, we'll see how to add Arduino library in Proteus software. Okay. So for that, I will start the Proteus software. So now I have opened the Proteus software. Now, whenever we want to create a new project for simulation, we have to pick the devices. So if I click on this P and if I type Arduino, I should get the component over here, but these are not the components, these are just the connectors for Arduino. So to get the Arduino library in Proteus, we have to follow certain steps. Okay, so I'll close this Proteus software, and now we have to go to a website called as theengineeringprojects.com, and from this you can download the library for Arduino Uno. Similarly, the library for other sensors and components is also available on this website. The link for downloading the library is given in the description of this video. So you have to download using this download button. Once you click on this, a zip file will be downloaded and you can extract that zip file. Okay, so I have already extracted it on my desktop. So you'll get this folder having name as Arduino library for Proteus. So if you open that folder, there are just two files. So these two files you have to copy and you have to paste these files in C drive inside this program data folder. Okay, so there is a hidden folder. You have to change your settings of your computer to show the hidden files. So only then you will see this folder. So you have to go inside this. Then you can go to this Lab Center Electronics. Inside that, there is another folder called as Proteus 8 Professional. So if you are using any other version, the name of this folder might be different. So inside that folder, there is another one more folder called as Library. So in this library, you have to just paste that files. So once you paste that files, you can close this folder and again you can open the Proteus software. So in this software, you can search again the component by typing here Arduino. Now here you will see different libraries or different components are available for Arduino. So first one is Arduino Mega, then Arduino Mega 128.0, then Arduino Mini, Nano and so on. So I will choose this Arduino Uno. I will double click on this. Then I can take one more component as LED. So I will choose this LED. Okay, now I can take this component, I can place it here and I can perform the simulation. Okay, so for just demo purpose, I will take one LED and connect it to pin number 13 and we'll run one sample program for blinking the LED. Okay. So this is the circuit that we have created. Okay, now we must put a hex file or executable file inside this component in order to execute the program. So for that, again, we'll need Arduino IDE. So this is the Arduino IDE. I can go to this file and I can click on this examples. Then I can go to this basics. I will open example called as Blink. So this Blink is used for blinking the LED with a delay of 1 second. Okay, so once you open this file, you can compile it. Then in order to get the hex file, you can save this file or you can save as. I will save it on desktop. Click on save and I can export the compiled binary. So if I click on this, whatever hex file is there, that will be exported. Okay, now I will close this. You can see here there is one folder created. So inside this folder, we have this blink.ino.standard.hex file. So I have to browse this file in my Proteus component. So I can double click on this Arduino board. I can click on this program file. And I can go to the folder where that file is saved. So it is saved in this Blink. So I will select this standard.hex file. Click on OK and to check the output, I can click on this run button. So once I click on that, You can see here the LED has started blinking. Okay. So in this way you can download any library. The libraries for other sensors are also available on the same website. You can download the libraries and repeat the same process for all the components. Thank you.